My name is Vijay Kumar. So I am going to teach the subject of digital communications. So first of all, what is meant by communication is, general communication is nothing but a transfer of information from one point to another point. Okay. So generally, what type of information we are transferring means, so generally what are the different types of information means, so generally there is a, we can transmit some voice signal, otherwise some image, video, otherwise text message. So these are the some types of informations we are transferring from one point to other point. Okay. So generally these are in some different forms. So first if you take the voice, image or video, generally these are in the analog form. These are varying with respect to the time. So but in the case of text messages, general text messages we are using some alphabets. Otherwise we are using some numerals. Otherwise we are using some punctuation symbols. So generally these are the in the form of discrete in nature. Okay. So basically the information that is present in either analog form, otherwise digital form. Okay. So but in the case of digital communication, so the information may be in which either in analog form or discrete form, we have to convert into the digital form. Okay. So we are converting into digital form and we are transferring from one point to other point within the communication channel. Okay. So why we are going for the digital communication rather than the analog communication means, generally the basic advantage of the digital communication is, so first advantage is, so we can provide the security for the information. We can provide the security for information. Okay. So generally this is not possible in case of analog communication. Okay. So in the case of analog communication, if you take some voice signal, okay, so voice signal, so consider this is in the some particular random nature. So for this voice signal, if we want to provide the security, so we have to embed some particular data. If we embed the particular data, then we can't filterize the data. Okay, so you can't get the original data at the receiver. That's why we are going for the digital communication. Okay, in the case of digital communication, the data always is present in the either ones or zeros. Okay, so for these ones or zeros, we are using some logic or some coding methodology, and we are adding some redundant bits. Okay, suppose I am using one methodology, so there is an even parity concern. Okay, even parity, and I am taking the original data, that is 101000. So if you want to make this data as even parity, you have to add some extra bit, that is zero. Okay, so this is called as some encoding mechanism. Okay, so if you are using this encoding mechanism, so we can provide the security for the information. So the receiver doesn't know this encoding mechanism. Okay, so if the only permitted receivers only will accept the information, will remove the redundant bits, and will allow only the, we can get only the original data. Okay, so this is the one main advantage of the digital communication. Other advantage of the digital communication is noise immunity is very high. Okay, so noise immunity is very high. So that is the advantage for the digital communication. Suppose if you see the analog communication, when the noise is occurred in the channel, so we can't remove the entire noise. So by using some clipper circuit, we can remove only the some part of the noise. And within the inner waveforms, you can't remove the such noise. Okay, but in the case of digital information, suppose if you take some 1010. Okay, so this is some consider on digital information. When the noise is occurred within the digital information, we can entirely remove the noise by using some clipper circuit. Okay, so if we remove this noise, then we can get the data as one. And here also there is a noise, but here the value of the this value is always less than the binary one noise added value. So this value is very less, means we can treat it as a zero. Okay, so we can completely remove the noise that is present in either data bit one, otherwise data bit zero. So noise is immunity is very very high within the case of digital communication. And also the errors can be detected and corrected by using some channel coding techniques. So there are correction detection by there is possible by using some digital communication, that is by using some channel encoder. So this is the other advantage for the digital communication. And other advantage is the multiplexing. Okay. So in the case of analog communication, we are transferring the different types of signals such as image, text, video, all these are in the different forms. Okay. So these different form signals we are transferring through the single communication channel. Okay. So but in the case of digital communication, all the information we are converting into the digital form, and this digital information we are going into the common channel. So this is the one advantage for the digital communication. Okay. So these are the some advantages for the digital communication. That's why we are going for the digital communication rather than the analog communication. If you see the block diagram for the digital communication, there is elements of the digital communication. So first one is the information source. So generally the types of information source are generally, it is a analog information source, and second one is the digital information source. Generally analog information source is nothing but first voice signal. It is a one type of analog signal, otherwise some images or some videos. Okay, so these are very with respect to the type. So this is called analog information sources. Otherwise next one is the discrete information source. The example for the discrete information source is some alphabets and otherwise some numerals. Okay, so these are the some examples for the discrete information source. These are the some information we are generating from the, or we are have to communicate to the destination. Okay, so there is a use of information source. Next block is the source encoder. Okay, so what is the main use of the source encoder? Means here in the case of digital communication, the information type, that may be anything, we have to convert it to only the digital form. So first, if you take the, if you consider the information source is some voice signal. Suppose if it is considered, it is in the some analog nature, that is sensor nature. Okay, so first we have to convert this voice signal into the digital form, that is some ones and some zeros. Further one, what we have to do means, we have to take some pulse train. Okay, so we have to take some series of pulses. So if you take series of pulses and we have to take some voice signal, these two signals you have to multiply, then we can get the some sampled signal. Okay, so this is some sampled signal. Okay, every sampled signal having some value. Okay, suppose consider this value is some 1.6, and next sample value consider some 3.2, and next sample value consider 4.6. So there are some, every sample there is a particular value. Okay, so generally this process is called as a sampling process. So sampling process means converting the continuous time signal into some discrete time signal. Okay, so a discrete time signal there is having some different sample values. After that we have to make some quantization. Okay, so we have to use some process called as quantization. So the main use of quantization is converting the value into the nearest integer form. Suppose if you take the 1.6, the nearest integer value is 2. If you take 3.2, the nearest integer is some 3. Next one is some 4.4. So every value we are converting to some nearest integer value. After that, we have to use some coding technique. Coding technique means every value we can convert into some binary form. Suppose if we have to some decimal value 2, we can convert into some 16-bit form, that is some 14 zeros, after that we can use some 1 0. Okay, every value we are coming to some digital form, that is 16-bit form. Okay,